Okay, we're back. Last time. Okay, we're back. So sorry about this. This is not my fault. This is every internet in every house. I was talking to a friend last night, FaceTiming on the opposite part of Los Angeles, and his internet crashed the second we started FaceTiming, and it kept crashing and crashing and crashing. Go ahead and sign on to your thing. We're gonna play some of the One Republic, the new album, some of the songs off of it while I'm cooking, okay? I wanna make sure you can see what it is I'm doing. There we go, numbers getting back up. Let's get them up. The internet, if anybody else is having issues with the internet around the world, they are pumping the brakes on the internet right now. That's a little better, yeah, that's better. That's the lighting, boom. They're pumping the brakes on the internet right now around the world because everybody's streaming, everybody's on Amazon, live streaming, you name it. But I can't do anything about that. So we're gonna keep this going. We're gonna play some One Republic songs. We're gonna try to join, if it works, One Republic. Tyler's gonna play some of the One Republic album upstairs. I don't know what songs you're gonna play, but there it is.
All right, we're live on a joint stream here.
All right.
All right, I'm gonna go upstairs to the studio.
Okay, so Tyler, once you get playing some of these songs, just turn them to a low volume so they can actually be heard. Does that make sense?
Of course.
Because what matters about this entire situation is that you actually get some food.
Okay? Of course.
Okay, so here's what we got to make this sandwich. This is a grilled cheese, y'all. This is a quarantine grilled cheese at quarantine cuisine. You need 2 slices of bread. The ideal bread is sourdough. But let's be honest. You're not going to go to the grocery store right now and get sourdough. Get whatever bread you have. It doesn't matter. Get any kind of cheese you have. In a perfect world, you've got 3 or 4 kinds of cheese. I'm going to stick to the Roy Choi Chef the Movie recipe as much as possible. He's using Gruyere, which is kind of the stinky cheese. He's using white cheddar. He's using yellow cheddar. He's using Parmesan. I've got kind of those. I have to switch up the cheeses. I'm also adding stuff that I want. We have some fresh liquefied butter here. You don't need to liquefy it. It just needs to be softened. I actually went too far on this. I got the Parmesan. I got mozzarella. None of this is fancy, y'all. This is quarantine. I got sharp cheddar. I got provolone. Here's the cool thing about this. You can go to a freaking gas station and get all of these ingredients. You can get, other than maybe the Parmesan, you can get every ingredient that you want. Human, what song should you play? Why don't you play Tyler?
Yes, sir.
List some of the titles.
I mean, I think it'd be cool to give them a little snippet of West Coast to start.
Yeah, we'll play West Coast. Okay, this is...
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
In the comments here, let us know how the volume is versus the cooking and if we need to turn it up or turn it down. All right.
I know you guys want to hear the music, but I don't want you to hear it 100% yet. I want this to be kind of like, you know, appetizer. So we're going to cook. We're going to play some songs in the background. In a perfect world, you see both of them. Or you can hear me, but you can hear the music a little bit. It should be background music. I've been dreaming about the West Coast. Can you all still hear me?
You're going to find out in a second.
Here's the cooking station. I'll get this figured out here. Watch. I've been staring up at the grayest skies, trying to find myself some luck, but it's running dry. It's like the rhythm. Okay. Here's what we got. Watch this. Bread. More bread. All right. 2 slices over here. 2 slices over here. Somebody's going to get the end piece. On one of these, I'm going to add something spicy. Watch it. Chip. All right, here we go. Watch me. I'm
Okay, that's good.
Now, I'm gonna slice up some garlic just to barely get some garlic in the bread because I think garlic's kind of dope. I'm gonna get this to where you can see it. Here we go. Yeah, girl, yeah. All right. Watermelon. Here's how we're gonna do this, all right? We got our bread,
Ryan,
we got our
cheese. Should we give him another snippet?
What other song do you wanna play?
Let's see, we got, you want me to just list off titles?
Yeah.
The fans have been waiting for this. We got Someday, we got Saviour.
Let's do a snippet of Saviour, just through the chorus. Let's just go through the choruses though. Let's not do the whole song. We'll do verse chorus, okay?
All right, guys, we're gonna breeze through some of these choruses here.
All right, so this is Provolone right here, guys. Provolone, okay? And before you play that, Tyler, what you're gonna wanna do, we're gonna put both pieces of bread down on the griddle. Use real butter. Don't mess around here. Or ghee, if you want to use ghee, which is kind of butter. But we're going to make the world's most perfect grilled cheese. We're going to knock your face off. We're going to get tongue boners, everybody. Get ready. Actually, let's do the cheddar first. I'm being honest with you. Go to the top of the verse. No excuses, bad behavior, but tonight I need to say. You like it? That's called Saviour. Yeah, Brazil. All right, where are some of you guys from? Let's see. Loving the new tunes. Thank you so much. One Republic, Brazil. Obrigado. Obrigado, Brazil. I think you should do a verse chorus. Italy, but New York City. I think you should do a verse chorus of Someday. What's up, Manila, Philippines, North Carolina? How y'all doing? You've shown up to Quarantine Cuisine. Welcome, Guatemala. Welcome, Oregon. Welcome, Iran. Welcome, Ukraine. We are making the grilled cheese from Chef the Movie, created by Monsieur Roy Choi. What's up, Oklahoma? Have a little bit of that, too.
All right, Someday coming up.
Tyler, do you want your grilled cheese spicy?
Sorry?
Do you want your grilled cheese spicy?
Always.
Okay. I'm going to add some jalapeno.
All right, boys and girls, this is Someday.
That's a cucumber. Don't add that. Someday will be all that we need. Up in the bed, screamed the words, been a ghost in a crowded room. Okay. All right, that's Someday.
That's all you get.
We wrote that song, by the way. I want the people to know. So we write these songs as we travel around the world. All these lyrics are informed by wherever we are. Someday was written almost entirely in Thailand. So if anybody's watching from Thailand, we wrote that and recorded a lot of it in Phuket and Bangkok. And I don't know what about Thailand inspired that, but it just, that's, those lyrics came from. I went for a long run in Phuket, and that's where I wrote most of those lyrics. I'm not left-handed. The camera's reversing everything. So before we play another song, which we're going to get to in just a second. Yeah, that's a summer song. Let me walk through some of this dish real quick, because this goes fast. Where in Thailand? Phuket and Bangkok. Concert was canceled in Chicago. I know. I was upset about that too, actually. Guaranteed a Christian. Tyler, have Ryan check his DMs after. Very important. Okay. All right. So we're making the world's greatest grilled cheese here, folks. And when I say the world's greatest, it is the greatest. Chef Roy Choi of the Kogi Empire designed this dish. It was in Chef the Movie. And I have been making this for 2 or 3 years. It is the greatest grilled cheese known to man. I don't have sourdough, which is the desired bread. But here's the thing. We're in quarantine. Most of you don't have most ingredients. We're trying to make some stuff here that you can actually make with basic ingredients, okay? All right, so before we play any more music, we're gonna get back to some music. One of the key ingredients to good grilled cheese is actually Parmesan. Thinly sliced, because Parmesan melts. It takes a long, it's a hard cheese. It takes a while for it to melt. So you wanna thinly slice it. And what I'm gonna do here is just slice as thin as I can. Little layers here. Yeah, come on, girl. I'm gonna make 2 grilled cheeses at the same time. One for Tyler, one for Brent, because I'm such a selfless guy. And I'm telling you, the secret to a good grilled cheese, I swear on my life, is mixing the cheeses. You have to have multiple kinds of cheeses all happening in harmony. So there we have fresh Parmesan. So we've got first layer, cheddar. Second layer, provolone. Third layer, mozzarella. Mozzarella is a great melter. Mozzarella. Now look, when you make this stuff, put Parmesan on the top, because Parmesan takes a while to melt and you want it to be the closest to the bread. So when you flip it, it's the closest to the heat. This is mozzarella, it melts quickly. But the Parmesan is gonna go on the very top because it needs to melt. It needs to melt the fastest. It's hard to melt. It's a hard to melt cheese. I'm adding some spice just because Tyler wants spice. So I'm giving him some jalapeno. This is going to be ridiculous retarded. And you know what? Do you want tomato or no, Tyler?
Yeah, sure, man.
Okay. We're going to do some tomato. And what I'm going to try on Brent's is I'm going to shred the Parmesan, because I think it might actually melt better that way.
Pro move.
Right? I'm a pro
you think,
guy.
If I just rattled off 3 song titles, why don't you pick the one you're okay. most excited about?
Sure.
Let's say Forgot About You, Distance, and Don't Cry For Me.
Play a little Forgot About You. And just but start first verse, chorus. That's it.
First verse, chorus. All right. Here we go.
Look at this. Look at this, babies. Look at this, internet babies. I forgot about what you said. I forgot about
That song slaps, Ryan.
Do y'all like that? Is that okay? It's totally different, isn't it? We did that with Andrew Watt, Louis Bell, and Ali Tamposi. This is going to be the best songs, I think, that we've ever compiled on an album. But again, that's subjective. The hardest thing about making albums over and over again for 13 years is you feel like you've said, yeah, Post Malone. Well, sure, he's a good dude. I'd happily welcome him on that song. But it's hard to keep rewriting the same thing. So you have to live life and then come back and make new albums. And you have to live enough life to have something to say. That's the hardest part about being an artist. If you're authentic, we write our own songs. Nobody's writing our hits for us. A lot of other artists, they get hits kind of delivered. And so we have to evolve. And there's a lot of fans that I was like, why don't you sound like Dreaming Out Loud, like 2007? The reason is we'd have like 1,000 fans total if we stayed with the same sound all the time. You know, I get that. You want your band, the artists that you like, to remind you of what they used to be, but evolve properly. And it's impossible to do that all the time. So we're trying to stay true to who we are. I will say, this out, if you hear the whole album, it is the most One Republic sounding album that we've ever done. On that note, this weekend, I want to sit down and do a playthrough of Native, the album, track by track, live stream on One Republic and my page. And we're going to talk about each song, where it came from, read your comments, ask your questions. Any questions you had about any song on Native, we're going to do. We're also going to go back to Dreaming Out Loud and do the same thing. But this weekend, probably Saturday or Sunday, we'll post it tonight. We want to do a giant listen through and talk through of the Native album. All right, I've got some butter cooking. Let's get to the food for just a second, because I ain't trying to waste this butter. I got 2 different pans going, and I got butter in the middle. Two different paninis going. We're gonna get some more music in a second, but check this out. I'm gonna hit Tyler's with just a little more spice because he loves that stuff. Mom, and I'm going to do something very, very, very questionable. Watch what I'm about to do here. See these? These are delicious. These are Cheez-Its. Ranch. I'm gonna put a little crunch in some of these. I'm making like a super gourmet grilled cheese, but I'm also throwing a gas station right in the middle of it. This is gas station gourmet tonight. That's so damn good. Okay. These suckers are ready to go. Here's why I have to be very careful, because I don't want to mess up what we're actually using. I saw that. Okay.
Hey, Ryan, while you grill those up, do you think we should give them one more?
I think so.
One more.
What do you think we should do?
I mean, they've heard better days.
If we're better days, I mean, we have a lot of songs. Why don't you do? You can play. Yeah, name a few more titles.
Distance, maybe.
I'm about to wash my hands. Distance. Okay, so Distance. This song. We finished it in Paris. Yeah, West Coast to be on Human. We played here. Distance is. I love this song. I'm not going to tell you what it's about, but we finished it in Paris, and we did it with Jason Evigan of Billboard and Casey Smith, who wrote Moral of the Story by Ash, who's Moral of the Story might be my favorite song out right now, actually. Anyway, go ahead and play a first course of Distance.
Got you, bro.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna sign off, and it'll be back to you just doing quarantine.
That's fine. We're about to wrap this up.
All right, here comes Distance.
Yeah.
That's it.
All right. Thank you, man.
Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for tuning in, guys. All right. Stay with me. Stay with me. I'm still making food. All right. We switched over to me now. Beautiful. That's beautiful. Okay. Checking the underside of this. You have to be so cautious with this stuff. Like super low heat. When you do these grilled cheeses, super, super, super low heat. Because these things will overcook in a nanosecond, okay? Look at this. Look at this right here. Look at that. 3-4 kinds of cheese. We got jalapenos, we got tomatoes. I'm gonna shift this. I want you to see me make the whole thing top down. So I'm gonna pause this one real quick. I'm gonna make Tyler's, okay? Throwing some fresh butter on here. Softened butter. Oh, girl. Look at this. You want the heat super low because these grilled cheeses, the problem is the bread cooks like that. It cooks like that. And once this burns, it's done. So I got this at about as low as I can get it. We got a piece of bread right here. Both pieces. You want to use real butter. So to update everybody, real, like this is, look, we're in quarantine here. I didn't go out and get fancy stuff. We got mozzarella, we got provolone. We got the one solid, awesome thing that we grabbed is real Parmesan, and we got cheddar. In a perfect world, you have Gruyere, white cheddar, yellow cheddar, and Parmesan. Those are the four cheeses that you want. Always put the Parmesan on the top. Always put it on the top. And then on one of these, I added some Cheez-Its just for some crunch. If anybody wants to know, my favorite potato chip in the world is this brand right here and this flavor. Honey Dijon Kettle. I've never been a drug addict or done drugs, but I imagine this is what cocaine in 1985 feels like. And good. You gotta watch this like a ninja. Yo, you gotta watch this like a ninja. This sucker will overcook on you in 1 second. And then what you do, like how do you get everything to melt so perfectly when you're making grilled cheeses? Once you have the cheese melting and everything kind of feeling awesome, I'll cover the top. I'll take a little bit of water, pour it in the edge away from the bread so it doesn't get the bread wet. It steams and then close it, and the steam will melt the cheese. Watch, I'm gonna do it here in a second. I'm gonna get a cup to do the water. Bang. You don't wanna do much though. In a minute, I'm gonna answer some questions. It can be about food, it can be about anything. Come on, girl. Yeah, right. It's perfect right now. I just don't want it to get not perfect. And I've got the other grilled cheese over here. I'm icing this other grilled cheese. I'm getting ready to put it back on. I've only got room to make one at a time. This is about ready to close. Here, I'll answer two questions real quick. Okay. Do that to reheat pizza. Yeah, that works too. Questions. You're the best. Thank you, guys. I hope you like some of those songs. There's a lot more. There's like 13 songs. My favorite album of all time is the Beatles' White Album. I actually just bought, this is interesting. The Beatles' White Album was what made me fall in love with the Beatles and made me realize that we'll never be the Beatles. But about a month ago, I found, before it went to auction, the original handwritten lyrics of While My Guitar Gently Weeps by George Harrison and Ringo Starr by the Beatles on the White Album. I found the original lyrics written on the back of like a studio invoice from the 1960s, and I bought those lyrics, and I'm framing them, and that's going to be my favorite thing that I own. What's your favorite food to cook? Anita. Looks like Anita might have joined. All she gives me is a hmm. But what does that even mean? Hey, Copeland. Anita, what does hmm mean? You don't think it's the best album? And then Anita, WTF. Who's my favorite artist to work with? Who do you think? Anita. Anita. Represent Brazil. Favorite song by The Script? Oh my God. Break Even. I know it's like, that's generic, but it is. Anita's album, by the way, and we get a lot of Brazilian questions on here. It is insane. I don't want to talk about it because it's not what I do as a producer, but the number one goal was to make sure that all of her fans that exist now in Brazil and around the world, that they're treated as number one, and that everything is, we're basically taking care of that core family that she has and working backwards from there. We have some Spanish records. There's a little Portuguese. We have some cross language stuff, but we're using the best of the best people. And it's been so much fun. It's ridiculous. Honestly, some of my favorite sessions I've ever had. And a good sign about any artist, when you're having that much fun, stuff tends to work out. It's the way it flies. Okay. One last question. I'm in dirty New Jersey. That's not a question. Come on, sing for real. What would you want me to sing? Let's Hurt Tonight. I'll sing one chorus of Let's Hurt Tonight and then I get back to cooking because I don't want this grilled cheese to burn. Oh, there we go. Yes. It's actually perfect. This is actually perfect. I'll sing a chorus of Let's Hurt Tonight. Got a little bit of jalapeno on here. This is perfect. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. A couple of these jalapenos fell off. This is perfect. All right. We're about to close this grilled cheese up. I'll do a chorus of Let's Hurt Tonight. You all want to hear it. We get more requests for Let's Hurt Tonight than almost anything else. So I need the lights and you lock the doors. Let's say all the things that we couldn't before. Don't walk away, don't roll your eyes. Let's say love is pain, well done. Let's hurt tonight. If this love is pain, then honey, let's love tonight. You don't even understand how beautiful this grilled cheese is. Lord, help me. Oh my God. Y'all, this is, hold on, you have to see this. This is what happens when you care. Look at this. Look at this madness. I'm doing a screenshot of it just because I don't believe it. Look at that. Super low. You see how low that is? I can like put my hand. Oh, actually, never mind. Don't do that. That hurts. That's crazy low temperature though. That's the secret to these things. Look how low that is. The lowest setting. It's almost off. Anything higher than that on a grilled cheese, if you try to make it fast, we've been making grilled cheeses since we were like five. If you try to make a fast grilled cheese, you're going to burn it. I've burnt 50,000 of these things. Way too easy to burn. Once you got that going, look at this. Watch this. Just press. Got a little missing jalapeno. Oh, God help us. We need Lord Jesus come in here. Do something about death. Oh my God. Okay, this guy's pretty much ready to go. Now I'm gonna show you how to flip this ish. See, even the Parmesan, you see that? That's why you gotta put Parmesan on the top. That junk is hard to melt. You see that? Let me show you the coffee. I saw the coffee question here. Here's what we got. We were just on tour. So I don't know who all is joining every single day. It's different people. We got more people tonight watching me cook than last night. So God bless y'all. We were on tour when Corona broke out, and we ended up canceling Milan, which breaks my freaking heart because I love Italy and Milano, che bella città. But I'm a coffee hound. So we were in Amsterdam for 6 days, killing time before we played Utrecht. And we hit every cool coffee shop we could. This was our favorite. It's right in the central district. Check it out. It's right near Cafe Il Momento. If you guys go here, if you live in Amsterdam, go here. It probably still smells like me. There's probably some crumbs from a lot of the food that I ate sitting there. This sucker's ready to go. Watch this. Look at this. Look at this monster. My God. Hold on. I'm going to put you back here for a second. This is unfair how good this is. Clear some of this cheese off. I got to make another one. Let's get a knife worthy of cutting this. Quarantine cuisine. Unsheath the knife. Okay, this is that moment though. I feel like you need to see it. Get rid of that Parmesan. See, and you just go really fast. Hear that crunch? Oh my God. Watch this. Here's how you plate it. See that? This sucker is a monster. This is quarantine cuisine at its finest. Yes, my hands are clean. Anybody wondering? And then we're going to top them. Just because a lot of us are buying food from gas stations right now. How's that look? Hey, Tyler! I'm about to eat his food. Yo, Tyler! Here he comes. Yo, come get this, man. Yeah. Get it before it's cold. Get it before I put COVID-19 all over it.
You still streaming?
Yeah.
Yo.
Dude.
Whoa.
Take a bite and tell me. Level.
Tomato, jalapeno.
Yeah. What do you think?
Delicious.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. All right.
All right. Game over.
Did it again.
Uh-oh. Oh, snap. I just snapped whatever this is. How do you keep this from breaking? The thing that holds the thing. That's
you go back in time.
I think go back in time and don't break it. All right, so I have one more of these to make. All right, so I'm going to post this entire recipe here. It's actually very simple. This was a relatively short quarantine cuisine. You got to hear some music. I'm going to post the recipe. I'm going to post the original recipe, and then like everything else that I make, you add what you want. You make it like the pasta dish last night. I added shrimp. I added tomatoes. I added white wine. I added basil. It didn't call for any of that, but it made it better. And that's the point, is you do you. Who cares what the recipe says? You do you. I do me. He does that. We do we. Love you. Thanks for hanging out with us. We will be back tomorrow night with more quarantine cuisine. This weekend, we're going to go through Native, the album, track by track. We're going to do a listen down live. Play a song. Talk about the song. Answer questions about the song. Do the next song, so on and so forth. Y'all be good. Boomer Sooner. Got any more questions? I'm going to do three last questions with you guys. Three last questions. What do we got? Honey, I love you isn't a question. It's a statement. That's just mostly I love yous. I like that. Will you have any Spanish lyrics on your new album? We're going to do a Spanish collaboration, so technically that would be. Interesting. Favorite Damien Rice song? That's a good question. That's a really good question.
Really good question. Take a deep cut.
All right, I have to pick a deep cut. I'd have to go through and like listen back to all the Damien Rice stuff I listened to. Where can you get a hat like that? MadTasty.com. What's your favorite dessert? My favorite dessert is ice cream, always. Did you use Kerrygold butter? In case you're Irish... Well, first of all, how much do I like ice cream? That's how much I like ice cream. Second of all, to the Irish person that just asked, Kerrygold. We know the Irish make good butter. Come on. And finally, third question. Am I a chef? No. Favorite city? It's hard to say. Probably Cape Town. I really like Wellington, Auckland. Favorite place to travel for vacation, Cabo San Lucas, Mexico. How do I keep my girlish figure? I don't eat that much food. It seems like I do. I eat what I want to eat. I just don't eat a lot of it, and I exercise. Favorite country singer right now? Ooh, Thomas Rhett. Thomas Rhett. I wrote his single that's out now. Come on. We have the hat in pink, actually. Pink letters, yeah. It's like tie-dye. My favorite song right now is Moral of the Story by Ash. Favorite Canadian city? Oh my God. Come on. Don't make me do that. I don't know. Montreal, Toronto, Vancouver. I like all of them. Asia tour. Yes. We're going to come back to Asia. We're going to do Mad Tasty in Spain. I love you guys. Thanks for hanging out with us. I think we're going to do, what time is it? 7:49? Two songs?
Maybe.
Two songs at like food and music. Maybe tomorrow. I actually, you know what? We're going to do music tomorrow. I actually legitimately need to rest my voice tonight. It's been killing me. We did a concert this afternoon with Global Citizen and to raise money for coronavirus, to fight coronavirus. And I'm technically supposed to be on vocal rest, but I didn't want to not do this tonight. So we will do music tomorrow. Thank you guys for hanging out. More new songs tomorrow. I'm gonna post this recipe for you guys. But I want to shout out to Roy Choi and Kogi because it's basically his. I take recipes and I mess with them until they're mine. All right. Love you. Peace. Get some sleep. Wash your hands. Wash your feet. Wash your bum. See ya.
So try.
Yes. And now.